South Africa. 1,500 miles of coastline. Perfect for swimming and surfing, were it not for one thing.
If you're swimming along the shores of Cape Town, that's a sound you don't want to hear, because it means that a great white shark is making its way towards the shore. That would have been what Henry Murray saw just seconds before his death. He was spearfishing just south of here. He was about 300 feet out, and one of these massive animals came in, took him up to his arms and its jaws, and then disappeared. Murray's car keys were found in a piece of his wetsuit. The question is, what happened here? To help us find out, with Rob Lawrence, an expert in these waters, just off Seal Island in False Bay, a place where we can witness firsthand a gruesome scenario that Murray might have faced. Rob, why do you think the shark has attacked Murray?
Well, one of two scenarios. Could be the fact that he was trailing fish around. Second of all, he might have been mistaken for a prey item on the surface. Just a very, very unfortunate scenario.
In this famous 2005 attack, Murray was spearfishing. Perhaps one of the most deadly things to do in shark-infested waters. He drifted away from his dive buddy at the time of this attack. Seal Island is one of the only places on Earth you can regularly see great whites eat live prey.
We got a shark on one right now.
He's chasing him right towards the boat.
Bam! Great white right beside him. I got it!
The sharks aren't afraid of the boat and chase the seal right past us.